Hi, welcome to keratoconus hub tv. Guys, are you enjoying my videos? Please let me know in your comments. Today I will tell you the impressive benefits of corneal collagen crosslinking to help you understand why it is mandatory to go for C3R if you have progressive keratoconus. In this video, I will cover complications and risks associated with the C3R. You will also know how much safe it is. So let's start with the benefits of crosslinking first. Following are the advantages of CXL procedure. Crosslinking halts the progression of keratoconus or slows down the progression or may improve vision in some cases. It reduces the chances of cornea transplant to great extent by stabilizing the cornea. It strengthens the cornea. It is a painless surgical procedure. No incision is required like other surgical procedures in C3R. Low risks are involved. CXL is an easy procedure. It can be used with INTACS for better vision. And at last, the faster recovery. Now let's discuss the complications of corneal collagen crosslinking. So the topic of discussion is CXL safe? What are the complications and risks involved? Although CXL is very safe, but still there may be some complications. These complications may arise either during or after the CXL procedure. So before discussing what these complications are, let me tell you the underlying causes behind these infections first. These risks and complications may be either short-term or long-term in nature. In CXL, complications may arise because of unsterilized or not properly sterilized medical equipments which are used in the surgery or poor hygiene of the patient. These may cause the infection. Complications may also arise due to the lack of expertise of the surgeon or because of applying incorrect technique. Here, the complications and risks of cross-linking have been mentioned. These are infections, temporary corneal haze, corneal edema, endothelial damage, herpes simplex virus reactivation, ocular surface disorders, corneal inflammatory infiltrates, excessive tearing, defects in epithelium, photophobia, painful eyes, halos, and the last one, treatment failure. That's all with benefits and risks associated with crosslinking. For more help about keratoconus, visit my blog www.keratoconushub.com. I will keep on adding more videos regularly to keep you updated. To get the notifications of my new videos, you can subscribe my channel, keratoconus hub tv. Thank you for watching.